My name is BJ Chandler, and I've been on staff for 3 years. I currently serve at the University of Florida. And one of the things I've found is the ability to tell a story and really can grip people's heart and can sometimes be the game changer in funding appointments. So first, when I finish my vision and 2 Timothy 2:2, this is why I do what I do, I ask the people that I sit down with if I could share with them a story of what that actually looks like on campus. So hopefully they say yes, and I haven't had anybody say no yet. So I'll launch into my first story. My first story talks about my time spent at the fraternity house in college. My sophomore year, I met a guy named Morgan, and Morgan came in his first week of college, came to know the Lord at church. He walks into my room one day and he says, "Hey, listen, I know we don't know each other very well. This is my first year on campus. I just became a Christian and I need some help." So Morgan and I began a friendship and did a ton of stuff together on campus and began meeting with him and teaching him how to read the word and how to memorize scripture. And we'd go shoot shotguns on the weekend and take road trips together and just became really good friends. Morgan's one of my best friends to this day. And over time, Morgan began to get a vision for what it would look like for him to pass his life on to the next generation. So kind of fast forward to Morgan's senior year of college. He's also living in the fraternity house. And one day he goes down to get his laundry done and meets a guy named Blake. Now, the night before, Blake is not a believer and didn't know Jesus. The night before, Blake went out on the town. And you picture in your mind what Animal House might look like, kind of a similar picture of the fraternity house. Well, Blake came back from that night partying, and he went to town on our dining room area in the fraternity house. He was throwing chairs around, and he grabbed the ketchup and mustard bottles and kind of did his Picasso on the walls and on the ceiling in the house, and just had a bad night all around. Morgan walked in the room and saw Blake on his hands and knees cleaning up the mess from the night before, and he could just tell, his heart went out to Blake. He could just tell that Blake was not in a good spot and didn't want to be there. So he took a break from his laundry and struck up a conversation with Blake and really just shared his story. Morgan shared his story with Blake about how he knew what that felt like, the despair and just the shame of the night before. And Morgan invited Blake to read the Bible with him. He shared his testimony, and Blake said, "Yeah, let's do that." So the next, really, 12 months, the next year, they met together, sometimes a couple times a week, sometimes a couple weeks would go by, and they would get in the Word with each other and just maintained a constant friendship and communication over the gospel of Jesus. Read through Mark and Romans and Genesis together. Well, a year later, Blake goes with Morgan to church, and an altar call was given, and Blake's in tears, and Morgan's in tears, and Blake surrendered his life to Christ. And I was lucky enough to be there that day, and it was a beautiful, beautiful thing of Morgan just investing time and friendship in Blake's life. And Blake came to know the Lord. Just a beautiful picture of one generation to the next generation.